And this leads to the second big discovery that has been made. The physicists have discovered that our actual universe evidences what's called fine-tuning, mm-hmm. that the fundamental parameters of our universe, the strength of the basic forces like gravity and electromagnetism,
are so
or the speed of light, or the rate of the expansion of the universe, or the force that produces that expansion, or the masses of the elementary particles, that all these fundamental parameters are finely tuned. That is to say, they fall within very narrow tolerances or very narrow ranges which allow life to exist in the universe. And in some cases, those parameters falling within those narrow ranges are necessary just to allow basic chemistry to get something beyond hydrogen. You know,
or illustrated the other way, the fact is that some of the guys have said there's a big machine, you got all the dials, and they control all of these fine parameters of the universe. Go from
right,
there.
Well, right, this is an illustration we talked about from Sir John Polkinghorne, the great Cambridge physicist, who became later in his life an Anglican priest after a religious conversion. And Polkinghorne used to illustrate the fine-tuning by asking you to imagine that you had docked at the space station that included the universe-creating machine for the whole universe. And you went in, and there was the console with the dial for the gravitational force constant, and another one with a dial for the strength of electromagnetism, and another slider that determined the speed of light, and on and on. And because you're a physics geek, and you work with your pencil and your slide rule, you quickly calculate that if any of these parameters were shifted by one click this way or that way, then life in the universe and maybe even basic chemistry would be impossible.
And not only that, but it would throw every one of the other dials off.
Well, possibly, or just all of them needed to be just right simultaneously.
That's
was the main idea. And so Polkinghorne used to ask his audiences when he lectured on this, well, what do you make of that? And I mentioned in a previous interview with you that I had a chance to interview him, and I asked him that question, and he said with his high Oxbridge accent, well, I don't say that the atheists are stupid. I just say that theism provides a more satisfying explanation.
Right.
And again, we found that the physicists who encountered this evidence said, as Paul Davies, a great British physicist, said, the impression of design is overwhelming, or as Fred Hoyle put it, a common sense interpretation of the fine-tuning evidence suggests that a super intellect has monkeyed with physics and chemistry to make life possible.
Mm-hmm.
And so the fine-tuning evidence is the second big discovery. The universe had a beginning, and that suggests the need for a transcendent cause beyond the universe to bring it into existence. The fine-tuning evidence suggests a transcendent cause because this affects the whole of the universe, but also a transcendent intelligent cause necessary to set those parameters up so that we live in the Goldilocks universe that physicists are talking about.
Transcendent simply means it had to be outside of the universe, because at first, if he brought it into existence, there was nothing. And so he had to be outside of time, space, matter, and so on. That's why we call it transcendent, and he brought it into existence.